Hi, meteorologist Paul Dorian here on Tuesday morning, November 30th, the last day of the month of November. It looks like it'll turn out to be slightly colder than normal month for much of the mid-Atlantic region, much of the eastern U.S., whereas the western half of the nation has turned out to have a warmer than normal month of November. Nothing real major coming into the mid-Atlantic region, the northeast U.S. over the next few days, but it's an active pattern and a lot of minor waves of energy are passing through. There's one right now, a little upper level disturbance that is causing some snow shower activity. Certainly the Virginia suburbs to the west of the District of Columbia have already seen some snow shower activity in some places. It's the first snow of the season. Manassas, for example, Culpeper, for example, got a little touch of snow earlier today. Those snow showers are now working their way to the east across the DC metro region, and there's still several snow showers right now falling across central Pennsylvania. They'll make their way into the southeastern part of the Commonwealth over the next few hours. New Jersey, New York City can see some snow shower activity. Again, another chilly day. It remains chilly on Wednesday and then much milder and becoming windy on Thursday. Well, I thought we'd kind of review a typical La Nina type of weather pattern. We are entering a winter season here with another La Nina set up across the equatorial part of the Pacific Ocean with colder than normal sea surface temperatures throughout much of the equatorial Pacific Ocean, much like last winter season, by the way. In a typical La Nina winter season, the polar jet is the dominant jet streak, and that's what you see on this particular graphic right here, the polar jet, as opposed to the southern branch of the jet stream. If El Nino conditions dominate, typically you have a much stronger southern branch of the jet stream, bringing in a lot of moisture across the southern U.S., but this is typically what you see in a La Nina type of winter. Of course, every single season is a little bit different from a prior one, but this is kind of a composite of La Nina winters, and so far it's holding pretty true to form in many parts of North America. For example, Alaska has certainly suffered through some intense cold this month of November. I have a blog right now on the homepage of paratonweather.com discussing the intense cold that the state of Alaska is going through. Now, normally it's cold this time of the year in Alaska, but this is unusual even for Alaska standards. I think many spots will end up with the coldest November ever. And that's saying something for the 49 states. Fairbanks, for example, way below zero for the last few days and the next few days, some 15 to 20 degrees below the normal for this time of the year. So that's holding true to form for a La Nina type of winter. Notice also very wet pattern, typically across the Pacific Northwest into the southwestern part of Canada, and indeed British Columbia, for example, has had some intense rainfall over the past several weeks and will continue to do so over the next several days. And by the way, intense snowfall in some of the interior higher elevation locations. In fact, we'll take a look at a snow map for the next 10 days and some incredible amounts across southwestern Canada. Meanwhile, some of the cold air does make its way all the way into the mid-Atlantic region, kind of a hit or miss type thing. In a typical La Nina winter for the mid-Atlantic region, some cold air masses, ups and downs in temperature pattern. Again, November looks like it'll turn out to be slightly colder than normal. The next 5 or 10 days or so, kind of an up and down type of pattern. Much milder conditions on Thursday, much colder air again returns for the early part of next week. Well, here's in fact the snow map I was just talking about for the next 10 days. This is from last night's operational run of the GFS at 0Z. And just wanted to point out how it really goes along with that polar jet that we just saw on a typical La Nina winter season. The polar jet dominates, kind of pulls in some cold air across the northern plains. Some of it makes its way into the Mid-Atlantic region. Certainly, more often than not, it makes its way into New England and southeastern part of Canada. A lot of snowfall expected up in southeastern Canada over the next 10 days, some all the way into the Mid-Atlantic region. And take a look at some of these numbers here. Look at this, 93 inches right here in southwestern Canada. This is some of the higher elevations, British Columbia, where, again, a ton of rain across coastal sections over the next several days, but a lot of intense snowfall in those interior higher elevation locations. Well, one other thing before we leave this map. Notice some snowfall getting pretty close, if not in the Denver, Colorado region. Unusual circumstance out there. They had the snowiest winter ever, officially, last winter season in Denver. What happens this year? They haven't had snow yet. It's the latest start for the snow season in Denver in their recorded history, following the snowiest winter ever. And again, not only was it the snowiest winter last winter season, it was very, very long. It started all the way back in September and extended all the way into April of this year. But there is some snow for the Colorado Rockies over the next 10 days or so. Well, one of the things we've talked about is the Madden-Julian Oscillation and how that can move into different phases, which give a clue as to the temperature and precipitation pattern across places like the U.S. in the winter season. And this is the forecast map in green from the ensemble run of the GFS going all the way out to about the middle part of December. And notice it goes in what we call phase six into phase seven over the next couple of weeks, right in this region right here. The MJO kind of translates in a counterclockwise direction on this particular type of plot. And phase seven in this time of the year generally suggests colder than normal conditions in the central and eastern U.S. So we'll see if this holds true with the MJO signal over the next few weeks for colder than normal conditions in the central and eastern U.S. as we go through the first half of the month of December. Well, let's now walk through the surface forecast maps from last night's 0Z GFS model run. First of all, some snow shower activity in the Mid-Atlantic region today. There has already been some reports of snow in the Virginia suburbs to the west of D.C. early this morning. Places like Culpeper, Manassas out in that region. There can certainly be some snow shower activity across the southeastern PA, New Jersey, New York City over the next several hours. Nothing on the accumulation side, but certainly in some spots the first snowflakes of the season with an upper level disturbance pushing through right now. Now let's move forward here. By the way, notice this dark, dark blue here. This is associated with some intense snowfall in the higher elevations of British Columbia, and there's some tremendous rainfall as well along coastal sections here. Let's move forward. We have another chilly day coming on Wednesday, and then a warm frontal system can cause some rain showers tomorrow night, and maybe even some snow showers in some of the northern part of the Mid-Atlantic region. This is Wednesday evening as a warm front pushes from the southwest to the northeast across the Mid-Atlantic region. Then we get into the day on Thursday, and notice the isobar pattern between a Canadian low pressure area and higher pressure off the Gulf Coast region, and we'll have a west to southwest flow of increasing intensity on Thursday, and temperatures will respond noticeably well up into the 50s in the DC, Philadelphia, New York City corridor, maybe even touching the 60 degree mark in places like Washington, D.C. Then we move forward. Still pretty mild on Friday, but notice here high pressure starting to build into southeastern Canada with a strong northerly fetch of air going into New England, and eventually that colder air does work its way down into the Mid-Atlantic region for the upcoming weekend. So the peak of the warm-up will be on Thursday afternoon, still pretty mild on Friday, but then generally trends colder for the upcoming weekend with this high building into the northeastern part of the nation, southeastern part of Canada. And let's look ahead into the early part of next week. Certainly some interesting possibilities next week. Here we are in the Sunday forecast map, still cold Canadian high kind of dominating the scene across the eastern, southeastern part of Canada into New England. So it tends to get colder from Thursday to Friday, then Friday to Saturday, and Saturday to Sunday, kind of a downtrend in temperatures By the time we get to the early part of next week, there'll be another strong cold frontal system with rain showers ahead of it Sunday night, Monday time frame. And this will be followed by a real cold shot here into Mid-Atlantic region, Northeast U.S. by the time we get to Monday night, Tuesday time frame. Again, another windy, cold type of conditions following the passage of that early week cold frontal system. And it looks like all signs point to another disturbance, another storm system should follow fairly quickly, maybe 2 or 3 days later, next Wednesday or Thursday. We're talking a week from tomorrow, so this is kind of speculation phase here. And it all depends on how quickly that particular system races into the eastern U.S., but there could be some cold enough conditions for some snow, and at least in parts of the Mid-Atlantic region, especially the northern Mid-Atlantic and also across New England during the middle part of next week. So something we'll have to watch out for, and that is, again, a strong cold frontal passage early next week, and then there may be a system just 2 or 3 days later, something of interest to watch over the next several days. So a little bit of activity over the next few days, nothing major, but many spots could see the first snowflakes of the season this morning into the afternoon hours, and then much milder conditions arrive in the Mid-Atlantic region for Thursday and Friday. That's it for now. I'm meteorologist Paul Dorn.